Okay, I hope the first part of the video is clear and you understand that the three of the four components or movement essentials I think you need to program are shuffling mechanics, crossover mechanics, progression toward a crossover run, and what I'm about to show you is a specific how to stop out of a multidirectional movement, a shuffle or a crossover. We progress for shuffling. To review, you're going to use the push to base progressions and add speed. For crossovers, you're going to teach basic crossover technique and add speed. For progressions toward crossover running, you're going to start with basic marching and skipping and make it more specific leading up to crossover run. To teach multidirectional or lateral specific deceleration, I use something called the jump cut. And I think it's honestly adapted from combine training, combine specific training. I know I've taken this from somewhere. I just don't have the coach in mind or the specific instance where I really adapted this. And as far as language and what I call it, it's just something that is easily understood through my athletes. Okay, so if you've seen this before and with using different verbiage, I apologize. I just don't know where I learned this specifically. Okay. All it really is the general capacity, the general reaction to as I'm shuffling, okay, if I have to cross over or crossover run, it's the general anticipatory reflex to throw both feet out, to literally vomit both feet out in front of my body to stop in an angled position. So to adjust my legs out in front of my body, okay, with my hips, knees, and feet still stacked. I don't think this is a good position, even though this lead leg is. I don't want to put this leg at risk. So just preparing to stop with on one leg, okay, it might be essential in many athletic instances. But if I can get I can get my athletes stopping, changing direction, decelerating, using two legs more often, I think logically you're going to make them safer. You're going to reduce the chance of an injury. Okay, whether that's one stop per game, one stop per practice, two. Okay, again, it might not be sport specific because a lot of us tend to think that sports and field and court sport movement happens on one leg most often or most of the time. If I can at least anticipate, it doesn't matter what how I'm stopping. If it's an angular cut, if it's a multidirectional movement, okay, I want to get my legs out in front of me, okay, in an angled position at the same time. I don't want this to be a 1-2. I want the reaction to swing both legs out ahead of me, okay, here. And so that puts my legs in a safe, stacked position, hips, knees, ankles. It's also the most efficient position to push back in the opposite direction if I have to. Again, this is adapted from other professionals, so I just don't have a specific instance on where I learned it. You can make the connections. But how I teach it is this way. We start at a line. You can use a piece of tape or a low hurdle. All I'm going to do is from an athletic position, just throw my legs out underneath my torso without moving my torso and punch the ground. This is just called like a 2-inch punch or a line punch. All I want to execute and to get my athletes to feel is this angled position in which if I push away from the ground, my body is only going in one direction, and that's back to the left or specifically back to the direction that I came from. So we start on one side of the line, we punch, okay, and reset. Punch, okay, and reset. Trying to get your athletes to move their feet at the same time. The foot position shouldn't be too close. Again, it should be probably shoulder width. It's something in which they can feel very explosive to push back away from and change direction. I don't imagine you want to be too wide here because then this leg gets caught underneath you, and I don't think we ever want to be too narrow in a game-like instance or a game-like scenario. That might be specific for some combine training, technical instruction, but for most field and court sport athletes, I think you still want to be shoulder width, if not a little bit more. But the idea is to get those feet going out in front of you. You keep the hips, knees, feet in line. Prep the ankles, the knees, and hips with that triple flexion, ground anticipation or ground preparation. Stick and push. You can shuffle out of it. You can cross over out of it. You can cross over run out of it. Those are the progressions. I don't think I need to demonstrate those. You can install it in your plyo training. So if you move from warm-up to technical training to plyos and specific power, one easy way, if you're doing lateral jumps, or it's at a point where you're ready to install this, okay, if you're doing lateral jumps, I do think you need to begin with basic lateral jumps from an athletic position to an athletic position, okay? Got me? With arm, hip, knee, and ankle preparation. To make it a little bit more specific, and again, this is kind of blending technical training and other components, is start an athletic position, jump, throw the feet out in front, and be ready to do something athletic out of that position to give your athletes the best chance to change direction. What this eliminates, as far as speed and first step speed, is wasted time. Your athletes are going to find this position. All your athletes are going to get to this position somehow. Okay, because I can't do very much, ideally. I can't do very much from here to try to change direction. If they're really weak, yeah, that's might be how they move, but they're not going to be very successful. So the good athletes, okay, are eventually going to find these angles and push out of. What we're trying to do is we're trying to eliminate that, maybe you can call it a movement-specific amortization phase, where we stop in this position, we have to sway back and adjust, and then get moving. I want to already be in that position and anticipate that position by entering the cut with 2 feet and then pushing back out of it. So again, we do basic. Okay, basic, safe, low volume. Jump training, stick, okay? Make it automatic, stick, got me? Good knee spacing, good feet spacing, good foot to hip ratio. And then you blend, or you install that jump cut, whatever you want to call it, out of a shuffle, out of a crossover run. Shuffle, stick. Their stick should be a jump cut. Shuffle, boom. Shuffle, stick. Okay? Something that looks sport specific. Okay? Again, I don't get really too caught up in the cumbersome technical details with young athletes. You try to install some program that they can digest that day, see improvements. I think they really understand, and they can see within a couple repetitions using this jump cut or ground preparation technique that their body stops before they even plan to stop, because they hit the ground in such an efficient position, ready to stop and change direction, where they're otherwise used to being in bad positions, okay, and transferring too much weight over their plant leg, okay, and not being able to stop and change direction efficiently. Okay, so again, it might not be something that is quote unquote sport specific, because a lot of transitional movement happens on one leg, cutting and crossing over on one leg, but if you can get your athletes to stop more often, maybe one time over the course of the game by preparing 2 feet, you're going to have a stronger deceleration, you're going to have a safer deceleration.